Hello there, a very good afternoon. Thanks for joining us here on Urban TV. This is Family Unscripted. You know, we come your way every other Sunday at 4 p.m. and do not forget to catch the repeat at 9 a.m. on Wednesdays. Thank you so very much. Those of you who have joined us from in and around Africa, thank you. Thank you so very much. Now, today, a lot has been going on in our, you know, communities. We see children growing up and we're thinking, you know, all those things. So today in particular, we want to ask ourselves, we want to really understand, at what age should one leave their parents' home? When I say parents' home, you know what I'm referring to. At what age did you watching, what age did you leave your parents' home? So with me in studio are amazing people. I have with me very important people, and I'm very privileged that they took time to come and join us here on the show as we try to understand each other. I'll begin with the other side. She tells me she's called Catalia. Catalia. Man, some names I can't even pronounce. Catalia. Well, Catalia, thanks for joining us here. She is a model. Thank you very much for coming here. And next to her is a gentleman who is the CEO of Words Modeling World. Words Modeling World. That is the gentleman there. His name is Ismail. The other one I can't pronounce. I'm sorry. Yes, Ismail. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Your other name? Maybe somebody out there might.
I'm called Words. That's the name that every youth knows.
Wait, are you Ugandan?
Yes, I'm a Ugandan.
And your parents called you Words?
No, Words, it was just a business name which I had to create.
Makes sense. Thank you. And next to him is a lady. She's called Fatina. She is a human resource person. Fatina, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Right. Now, there's a gentleman. You all can see the uniform and stuff. I feel very secure right now. I feel very important. I'm like, yo, man. Oh, well. So, you're welcome, sir. He is called, he is CP. What is CP?
Commissioner of Police.
Okay. Now I know. Commissioner of Police, Kafeero Moses Kabugo. And he's the Commander Kampala Metropolitan Police. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
The reason why I'm reading off my book is making sure I have people's names and designation right. Now we can start the show. You're very much welcome. So I'll begin with Catalia. Are you still staying with your parents?
Right now I'm not staying with my parents. I'm staying alone. Yeah.
At what age did you leave your parents' home?
I was 19.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. That's okay. And how does it feel?
Still, it's not like I'm that much independent because my parents still support me in some way. And where they cannot help me, I help them, like finding those stuff that they did not provide for me. Like when the money is not sent yet, I don't have to wait until, or I don't have to suffer a lot. I have to help myself get the what I need. Yeah.
So that you are out of their house, but they still support you.
Yeah, they still support me.
Wow, amazing, amazing. Ismail, at what age did you leave your parents' home?
19 years.
Wait, is it a thing of 19 years?
No, no. I just had to leave the parents' home at 19 years.
Why? What prompted you?
Okay. Due to the fact that I felt uncomfortable.
What do you mean uncomfortable with your parents?
Because a man has to work. That's what I mean.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, huh?
So, there, I had to sit down because I used to love fashion. I became a model one time. Mm-hmm. Then I had to go to different modeling agencies until I had to see there is something lacking into girls and boys, their dreams to be fulfilled. There I come with a modeling agency. We start now, right now it's 3 years. It's going on very well because it's the top modeling agency in Uganda right now.
Wow, well done. I'm really proud of you. But I'm still very concerned. You were uncomfortable in your parents' home.
I feel so bad when my dad gives me money. at a 19-year-old.
He's your dad. He's supposed to provide.
It's not supposed to be like that. Okay. They are an adult. I've passed 18. Mm. I need to go work. I need to go sketch, sit, plan. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wow, that's really good. I hope some people, there are people who are like 40 or 36 and they don't think like that. Fatina, you've heard from these people at 19, they moved. This one is because he wasn't comfortable. The other one is just because, well, let me just be out here, but you're still supporting me. What do you think?
Personally, I think it's different for ladies and for boys. Mm-hmm. My opinion is, for boys, one should not go back home after campus. Mm. After campus, just like Ismail has said, you're now an adult. I would think that it's now time for you to hustle. For a girl, the most appropriate is wait for marriage.
Oh, wow. Wow, that's
so really for a girl, you're permitted to stay home, should I say, till 35 if you're not yet married. But I'm very sure by 35 you've found someone.
Are you still staying in your parents' home?
No. Okay. I'm not staying in my parents' home. But that is my opinion. Mm. Though that is supposed to be the ideal.
Okay.
But the reality is like the economy has changed. You see, the boys who have a mindset like Ismail are very few.
Very few.
Very few. Right now, our parents make it very comfortable for us to stay at home. You leave campus, and when you leave campus, actually your mom says, oh, there's our boys' quarter, let's refurbish it for Ismail to come back home.
You know?
So by the time you come back, most definitely you're very comfortable. They furnished the boys' quarter for you. So the generation is changing. Mm. But the ideal should be after campus, a boy should go and start hustling. Yes, if things get hard, the parents can give you a push.
Yes.
But ideally, go and hustle.
Wow.
For the girl, please come back home.
I don't know what the Commissioner of Police has to say about this, because there's a lot going on. There's kidnaps going on. There's you find children, okay, I'm not going to call them children, 19, they're adults. Campus students, they're all over the place. And of course, the parents are not aware. And they're doing despicable things. Now, kindly tell me, you as a Commissioner of Police, what do you think?
Thank you so much. First of all, leaving home is relative.
Okay.
Sometimes, of course, and also it depends on the boy or the girl or a man or a young lady at a time.
Right.
I think the best time to leave home is when you get a job, because when you go out there and you don't have any livelihood, you'll face challenges.
Yes.
So the best thing is after university or college, hang around home as you search around, because you can scavenge on some of the things that relatives bring or parents buy, and then maybe after 2 or 3 years after university, you've got a job, start that independent life. Same to the lady, you don't have to stay home. Fine, Hajat has the idea that you first wait for marriage, but I think you can start being independent irrespective of leaving due to marriage, provided you have a job, a source of livelihood.
Yes.
So when it comes to campuses, sometimes, as you have rightly said, some do not even wait to finish the course. By holidays of semesters, they are already having independent lives.
Know?
Even at campus, they stay in the hostels during the semester break.
Yes.
They're already not going home. And of course, it creates a risk, because sometimes they end up trying to look for livelihood and good life by getting sugar daddies. I remember at campus, you know, oh, you'd see the parking yard full at Mary Stewart, at Box and Africa. And of course, in the due process, sometimes they eat this man of these sugar daddies, and times comes and they seek revenge on their money sometimes. And they see this girl again going in for the agreement of the campus.
Yes.
Has been eating the money of a man twice or thrice the age. And sometimes it brings security challenges on their lives.
Absolutely.
So let girls finish school and boys hang around with the parents. Get a job as you hang around the parents' home. Then become independent. I would think it's the right way to go. But also that's the modern living. It changes a little in the rural sector. Sometimes, you know, in the rural side, you don't have to look for jobs. You have the risuku there, you can cultivate, you can, you know, pick coffee around.
True.
So when the mzee, when you grow up, that one 18 years are enough. As a boy, just put your manyata, grow a thatched house in the backyard and start life.
And start life, yeah.
Mzee's chivanja somewhere in the corner.
Yeah.
So the one we discussed earlier is the urban living. But in the rural, you don't have to wait for the job. Get 18 years, especially for the boys, get a corner of mzee's chivanja, put a small house, get a lady and start a family. Yep.
Wow, wow. That's very, very insightful. We'll take a break quickly, and when we return, I want to know, I want to hear from Katalia and Ismail how they managed, what challenges they faced, so that we can, you know, understand, those of us who, you know, are quite mature, like a bit old. We'll be right back.